All right, here we go, here we go, here we go. Today, I'm giving away $500. Today's episode is sponsored by MusicBed because we're partnering together to give away $500 to one of you. Yes, we are giving away $500 plus a one-year subscription to MusicBed by 500 bucks to buy whatever camera gear you need to film your YouTube videos, your documentaries, your short films, whatever. You can get a light if you want to, a tripod, a mic. You might be able to get a camera for 500 bucks, but $500 plus a MusicBed subscription for an entire year to one of you. We'll talk more about the giveaway towards the end of the video, but today I wanted to talk about how to film an interview all by yourself.
My name's Tyler Santangelo. I'm a lighting designer. When I listen to the music before I program, I like to try to feel an emotional connection myself. And I try to see, you know, what am I feeling? What colors am I feeling? And if that's how that makes me feel, how do I do that on a bigger scale?
When I think about when I started this, I knew I wanted to make these pieces, and I knew that it was going to get bigger, but the fact that it like became this giant man-eating kind of plant, I didn't know what I was getting myself into, but that's kind of what I usually do.
Creativity to me, this might sound really cliche, but creativity to me is fun, it's exciting, it's a challenge. There's so much to creativity. It's something that's like it's motivating. It's something that you love to do. It makes you happy. Creativity just brings out the best in you.
So long before I started making videos on YouTube, I filmed a lot of documentaries, a lot of mini documentaries, and a ton of interviews. And filming interviews are hard because you are trying to capture somebody's story. It's hard to film with a crew, but it's a lot harder if you are filming everything by yourself. Oh man, they're hard. They're hard. So before the actual interview actually begins, you gotta do a lot of prep work. So if you're working with a client, I would suggest just meeting up with them, whether in person or over the phone, and just kinda talk about what you want to film during the interview. Basically, in this section, which we'll call pre-production, you wanna prep as much as you can so that when it comes time to doing the interview, you have all your questions ready and you have a good idea of what kind of B-roll to film. Oh, and B-roll, I know there's a lot of B-roll videos out right now, but B-roll is meant to be complimentary footage to help tell the story of your main footage, which is the interview. So in this interview that I did with this amazing puppet maker, she talked about how she loved the creative process, how she made each puppet by hand. And so for B-roll, I made sure to capture shots of her in the creative process and her making these puppets by hand.
Just realized I blend in with the futon.
All right, so now the gear that you're gonna need to set up an interview so that it looks and sounds good. All right, so for camera, well, you can pretty much film with any camera. Like if you don't have the budget to buy a mirrorless or DSLR camera and all you have is a phone, then just use your phone. You could add a secondary camera if you have one or if you have the budget to get one. And if you do, I would suggest having a different angle than your main camera. You can even add your secondary camera on a slider to create some movement to your shot. A slider shot just looks real slick. It's just gonna increase the production value of your video. But if you don't have a secondary camera or a slider, then using one single camera is totally fine. Because more important than the visuals of your interview is the audio. You wanna make sure that the audio portion sounds good and clear. If you're filming an interview and it sounds good, but the audio is really distracting, then it's gonna make for a really bad interview. People can be more forgiving with bad visuals and less forgiving with bad audio. Like something about audio just psychologically just stops you in your tracks. Like if I'm watching like Avengers Endgame and then there's a baby crying behind me, like I'm not gonna enjoy watching the movie. I'll be like, you probably shouldn't have brought your baby here. It's Avengers Endgame. So don't worry about the camera you have or don't have. You wanna make sure that you focus on capturing clear audio. And with the $500 giveaway, you can get yourself a really good mic. Like a really good mic. Speaking of audio, there are several options that you can use. You can use a boom mic or you can use a lav mic, which is that little mic that you can clip on to your subject. Lav mics are great, especially wireless lav mics, because you can clip on a mic to your subject, whether it's on the tie or the jacket or on the shirt. Boom mics are good too, especially shotgun mics, because they're directional. They capture audio in a straight line. You can get a boom stand to hook up your mic and record your audio that way. You want to be about 12 to 18 inches from the subject's mouth. Anything farther than that, the subject will sound distant, and you don't really want your subject to sound distant. You want them to sound crisp and clear. So 12 to 18 inches is the general rule of thumb. All right, next, lighting. Now, you don't necessarily need to have a big studio light. Like the one I'm using right now is the Aputure 120D Mark II, and the light modifier that I have is the Aputure Lantern. Just produces really nice soft lighting. But if you don't have any lighting at all, then film by a window. Because if you're filming by a window, that'll produce big soft lighting, which will look really good on your subject. And if you do have a studio light, then I would recommend placing the light about 45 degrees from the subject. This is a good little angle to give a nice light to shadow ratio on the subject's face. It's very complimentary lighting and just makes your entire composition look good. Oh, and if you have a remote to control the light, like I would highly recommend getting one. Just makes your life a lot easier. Off, on, off, on. Oh, and if you can, try to add some light in the background, whether it's a back or hair light or just an accent light or like a lamp in the background or something like that. Like right now I have this tube light in the back and it just makes the entire shot look a lot more interesting. And that's pretty much it to film your basic interview. Like we could totally get more in depth and talk advanced techniques and all this stuff, but if you are filming an interview all by yourself, then it's probably a good idea to keep your gear set up simple. And now the interview. You want to start off the interview with some casual light conversation. Oftentimes the client will feel a little nervous, especially when there's a camera pointed at their face. But hopefully by then you've established a rapport with the client or the subject that you're filming to the point where they feel comfortable with you asking whatever questions you have. And then really for most interviews that I do, I just focus on the what, the how, and the why. So what the subject matter is about, who the person is on camera is about, and why is this story important. And those are the three things that I focus on when I ask questions for any interview. All right, so now the interview is done and you're ready to take the footage and bring it into your computer so that you can start editing. We're not gonna talk about the actual editing process itself because that should be a video on its own, such a massive topic. But what I do wanna talk about is music choice and how important music is when it comes to interviews. Music is so powerful because it sets the tone and the mood of your video. This is really important to me, especially when it comes to the storytelling aspect of interviews. And for me, my go-to place to use music for interviews is MusicBed. Like, the quality of music on MusicBed is just top-notch. Like, we're talking about record label quality music, music that you've heard in TV shows, commercials. I'm sure you've heard it through your favorite streaming platforms. MusicBed just has the best quality music to use, especially for interviews and documentaries. I think what makes MusicBed really special is that you can tell that there's storytelling in all their music. But these are songs where you feel the story, where you feel the emotion, and these are the type of songs that I love using for my interviews. But searching for music is super easy. Usually I start with browse and go through their many playlists, and oh, look at that. I even have my own. But you can search for music by using mood, genre, or by instrumental, which by the way is my favorite part about MusicBed. Like whatever song that you find, usually there's an instrumental version of that song. They've got subscription plans for pretty much all creatives. And so if you're a content creator, there's a plan for you. If you shoot weddings, there's a plan for you. Or if you're a business and you have a production company, there's a plan for you. And you can try them out for free for 30 days. Link below, free 30 days. Not bad. Now let's talk about the giveaway. $500 plus a subscription to MusicBed for an entire year. All you have to do is film an interview by yourself. That's it, that's all you have to do. Use the techniques that I talked about from this video, from the preparation to setting up the actual gear. Film your interview and send it to me on Instagram or Twitter and I will pick one winner to win $500 and a MusicBed subscription for an entire year. Oh, and you do have to use music from MusicBed for your interviews. And so if you don't have a MusicBed subscription already, then click the link down below for that 30-day free trial. All the details for the giveaway are down below, so make sure to check that out. But that's it for this video. Hopefully this was a good one. Thanks for watching, thanks for hanging out, and big thanks to MusicBed for sponsoring this video. Definitely check them out if you haven't already. But thumbs up, subscribe, hit the bell button, it's down below, and hopefully one of you will win $500. $500, wow. I can buy like more black shirts to match with my futon.